The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ
be with you all. In the waters of baptism, our brother Jerry died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. Pray. Oh Lord, we come here today and we greet Jerry with the waters of baptism and with the white garment of baptism. Jerry was one who lived out his baptism. He was one who was filled with love. He is one who let that water run through his whole life as he tried to share with others the goodness of God's love that came into his life in baptism, a goodness that he lived out day in and day out in his life, recognizing that Jesus had called him to be his messenger on earth. Jerry loved life and lived life to the fullest, and now has inherited the fullness of life. So as we greet his body, we are mindful that he is with the Lord, that he is at peace, that he strives and lives in the fullness of God's love. Let us pray for his family, for all of us. Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
We welcome you to Jerry's church. He was so much part of this parish and this church. Always faithful to be here for Mass, celebrating the gift of the Eucharist that was so important to him. He was always involved in the parish, whether it be on parish council or just doing things that helped the parish. He was a great source of strength to me in a project I had, spent many hours working on that. He had a great love for so many things. We come here today because we want to honor that love that was especially for Bonnie. Today's their anniversary. And we picked this day to celebrate because we believe that that love that the two of them have will continue as Jerry will look down upon her and bring her love and strengthen her always. And we come here today to think of his way of bringing love to others, his family, and especially Michael, who was so very, very special to him. The many things that they did together, he was always had time to do whatever Michael needed done, whether it was helping with scouts or Cub Scouts or whatever, he was there, going games, watching Michael grow, watching Michael be a very, very special part of his life and of his manifestation of Jerry's love by the way Michael lived his life. And so we all gather here because we've been touched by one who loved us. That's what's important. So let us ask God to help us always to remember Jerry's smile, his spirit, his zest for life. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Jerry, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Our first reading from the Old Testament will be done by Jerry's sister-in-law, Tracy.
Happy the man who fears the Lord, by joyfully keeping his commandments. Children of such a man will be powers on earth, be riches and wealth for his family, and his righteousness can never change. For the upright he shines like a lamp in the dark. He is merciful, tender-hearted, and virtuous. Interest is not charged by this good man. He is honest in all his dealings. Keep safe by virtue, he's ever steadfast, and leaves an imperishable memory behind him. With constant heart and confidence in the Lord, he never fear bad news. Steadfast in heart, he overcomes his fears. In the end, he'll triumph over his enemies. Quick to be generous, he gives to the poor. His righteousness can never change. Men such as this will always be honored. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm response will be led by Jerry's aunt, Kathleen.
To you, O Lord, I lift my soul.
To you, O Lord, I lift my soul.
Remember that your compassion, O Lord, and your kindness are from of old. In your kindness, remember me, because of your goodness, O Lord. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. Relieve the troubles of my heart, and bring me out of my distress. Put an end to my affliction and my suffering, and take away all my sins. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. Preserve my life and rescue me. Let me not be put to shame, for I take refuge in you. Let integrity and uprightness preserve me, because I wait for you, O Lord. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul.
The second reading for the New Testament will be done by family friend Bob Thompson.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to Timothy. Brothers and sisters, I am already being poured out like a drink offering, and the time has come for my departure. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
This is a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus answered, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
These words of today's gospel, I give praise to you, Lord, from the wise and the learned. but you have revealed them to those who find the simplicity of your love. I read these words to Jerry when I anointed him a week ago Tuesday. He was very heavily medicated. And as I read these words, as I celebrated with him for the third or fourth time the anointing of the sick, I saw a slight smile on his face. And for a moment, his eyes opened up, recognizing the power of God and the love of God. For he was a person that understood that great mystery. And while he was skilled and educated in the things of this world, the most important thing was the exuberance of love and life that he lived. And that is how he lived his whole life, right up until the moment that he went home on All Saints' Day to celebrate the fullness of God's love. He was a person who always chose to do the important things in life, to love, to serve, to touch, to be there for people. You know, when we talk about Jerry, we talk about his age, 51 years. It seems so short. And yet, I want you to measure your life, not in years, but in love. For Jerry was one who had the exuberance of youth throughout his whole life. There wasn't a challenge, there wasn't an opportunity to do something that Jerry would not choose to live life to the fullest. He was a person who was always doing different things. He was a triathlete. He was a person that always was in shape, always recognizing the power of God and doing, living that out in the good that he did. He was a person that always chose to be with people that he loved. He had friends from grammar school, friends from college, friends from all over. And one of the things that he marveled at was the goodness of you people, of his family and friends during his sickness. Every time that I visited with him, he would talk about you and what you wonderful people had done. And I don't think it ever crossed his mind that you loved him as much as he loved you. And he was special to you, as each of you were special to him. And so as we stay here today, we must look at his life, not in the number of days or years, for that was not what counted in his life. It was making each day, each moment, each second important by the way he lived his life, by the giving of himself, by the way that he so much touched his family, his wife Bonnie. What a great relationship of love. They did almost everything together. They were always there, and Bonnie was such a person that supported him. Sometimes she didn't want all he was doing while he was sick, but he did it anyway, and Bonnie let it happen. She, in her heart, said, don't go there, don't do that, you don't have to work this week, and yet he always kept doing that. That spirit of love that he had that he transmitted to Michael, always being there and always being special to Michael, and knowing that Michael's great love. That was a joy we talked about every time I came, the blessing of his son. And his most concern was about his wife, his son, his family, not about himself. We never talked about, really, his illness. Oh, we knew it was there and we recognized it, but it wasn't anything that we talked a long time about. Because his was, what could I do, even in my sickness? How can I go into the office today? How can I finish this one more case? How can I do this one more thing? How can I have my secretary come out with another brief, another legal thing, so I can keep going? How can I make plans even to go away in my sickness, go away and celebrate life? And that is the spirit that he wants us to remember, that spirit that led him to truly be a fighting Irishman. I put on my special St. Patrick's alb. Had to wear that today. Because we need to see him, that smile, the smile that lit up even in his eyes, and how proud he was to be able to do anything for anyone. I often thought of whenever he would start talking to me about a project he was working on, that he was back marching across the field at Notre Dame Stadium, you know, playing his instrument and shouting loudly. For he had that same exuberance about all he did. And he was so proud of his Notre Dame relationship, being in the band. A couple years ago, he went back and they had the reunion of the band and they went out in the field. What a special day that was to him. But it wasn't just being on the field at Notre Dame, it wasn't just being a Notre Dame alumni that was so special to him. It was how he lived that out in action, how he lived that out by loving God, how he lived that out by doing good for other people, how he was always ready to help, to do anything that he could to help other people. He was a person that tried to do all that he could to bring goodness into the world. He was an ethical person, and that was the most important thing to him, that his word was his bond, and that he would do all things that he could to bring the love of God to others. His faithfulness here in the church and the parish is well known to me. His counsel, his help in problems that I had as a pastor was a great consolation to me. He was a person that was a partner in his law firm, and he had spent his entire 26 years working in the career of law, trying to help people, trying to be honest, trying to have integrity, trying to touch people and help them, whatever their problem was. But it went far beyond that. It went into scouting and all those things that he did. He was an Eagle Scout. He was very, very proud of that. Not in the way that he was saying me, but he was saying how God blessed me, gave me opportunities that others did not have, gave me talents that others did not. Whether he went out to hike a mountain or whether he went out to walk a trail or to swim a marathon, those were all things that he did because God had blessed him. And he truly recognized that. He truly recognized the greatness of God in his life. And he used everything he could to give back to the Lord what the Lord had given to him. And I think all of us gathered here have been touched by him, touched by his love, by his smile. I always loved his smile. He just lit up a room wherever he was. He was a person that just loved, and he did everything he could to encourage us to be the best we could be. Always challenging people, always helping them, always reaching out to them. And so 52 years was really much more than that. 52 years of love, 52 years of seizing every opportunity he had to do whatever he could do to help people, to love people, to be there for people. His life is a life of love. And that is what really counts. For he believed in the gospel today that the burden of the Lord is light. And even in his sickness, his last year and a half, he carried that burden without difficulty. He always fought. He fought for every moment. He did anything. He went any place that could offer him help medically. And yet at the same time, he was willing to accept the final end. I went over to him shortly after the doctors had said there was no more that we could do. It was a Saturday morning. I went in and we sat down. Bonnie was there and Jerry. I had prepared what I was going to say, all the words of wisdom that I could draw up from my own spiritual life to help Jerry. I sat there for 15 minutes while Jerry said everything to me that I had prepared was and everything. He was always the next step ahead. He was always planning for the next event, always celebrating the next victory, always being filled with a zest for every moment being important, and that zest of sharing with others the greatness of God's love that had been shared with him. That very special union with Bonnie that was went on with both of them loving each other, always being there for each other, always recognizing the power of this day on which they were married, a power that gave them both new life, to be there for each other, to strengthen each other, to love each other. And then the blessing of their marriage, Michael. I remember going over when he was a very little kid, four or five, visiting their house. That special uniqueness that they found in Michael. And as he has grown in age and grace, he has been true to the call of his love, to love them always. So we have today a story of faith, story of love, a story of seizing the moment and living each moment to the fullest, so that life was for Jerry always full. Life for Jerry was not cut short because he had lived it to the fullest. And now he has inherited that promise, that a call to those who truly understand what baptism is all about. For baptism is a call not only to live out Jesus' life in this world, which Jerry did, but it is a call to inherit that fullness of life in the kingdom of heaven. And that is what Jerry has achieved. He has achieved it by living each moment in the love of Jesus. He has achieved it by loving each person that came into his life. He has achieved it by using his skills as a lawyer to help people. He has achieved it by his joy that he brought to so many of us, his smile, his love. And so today, as we come here and we remember him, we have to remember him in a way that we are going to be a lasting memorial to who he was. That each of us touched by his love must in turn love. For that is what Jerry would want us to do, to pass it on. Not to hold on to love, but to share love always. For that is what he taught all of us. And so today we come here because of a gracious God. A gracious God who Jerry recognized and lived for in his life. And now we know that that gracious God has taken Jerry to himself. That he's rewarded for his goodness, for his love, even for his suffering. And now he has found the greatest joy of all, everlasting love in heaven. Let us stand. Lord Jesus, you call us to be your children, to be blessed by you and to be called to live your life and to bring your love into the world. We thank you for the gift of Jerry, who has brought so much zest to our lives, so much love. And we ask you to help us through these petitions to let his spirit live on in each of us.
Our brother Jerry was nourished at the table of the Lord. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who loved and were loved by Jerry, that we may find comfort in our belief in the Lord's promise to us of eternal life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each of us with whom Jerry so generously shared his many gifts, may we too grow in the ability to enlighten the burdens of others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who have died in the hope of rising again, especially Jerry. Welcome him, Lord, in the light of your presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Jerry's family and his wife, Bonnie, his son, Michael, his parents, Michael and Barbara, his brothers, Sean and Tracy, and their family. Jerry also leaves Bonnie's parents, Bob and Vera, along with Bonnie's siblings, Carol and Larry, Jim and Janie, Rick and Sue, Tom and Michelle, Kate and Dave, Rich and Joanne, Laura and Doug, and Tom and Robin, and their families, his extended family, and numerous close friends, co-workers, and clients, that they will know the peace of the Lord in the time of sadness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for each of us here present that God will bless us richly with his gifts. He knows we need to fully celebrate life and recognize the new beginnings which he offers us each day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, you bless us. You bless Jerry, and through him, you have blessed all of us. Let us recognize the blessing of God, and let us live that out. Let us be faithful to our church. Let us be faithful to our families. Let us be faithful to our friends, for we have been inspired by one who had all those qualities, and we must remember him by honoring him and taking on those qualities in our lives, so that we might bring the spirit of God's love alive in the world today. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
The gifts of bread and wine to be used at this Mass will be brought forward by Jerry's nephews, Colin and Liam, his niece Elsa, Bonnie's nieces Rachel and Alyssa, and Jerry's aunt Rosemary.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God,
the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Jerry, we beseech you that you may grant to him the fullness of your love forever in and through your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for it is at your summons that we come to birth, and by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return to give an account of our lives and to proclaim our love for you. And when you give us the sign you have been, that we have been redeemed by your death and of your Son, and we shall be raised up in the glory of the resurrection, and so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heavenly, holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Please kneel or be seated, whichever is your tradition. Those who are standing can remain standing. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once again, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the body, the bread of life, and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Salvatore, our Bishop, and all the clergy and the people of God.
Remember your servant, Jerry, whom you have called at this time from this world to yourself. Grant he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Let us stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace and love. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul. We'd ask you who are going to communion to come up in two rows in the center aisle. There will be four ministers of the host across the front, and there'll be ministers of the cup, two ministers of the cup at the side. So come up the center and go back by the side. If you'd like to receive under both species, you can do that. The side room will have a special minister there for those in the side room. If you're not going to communion, just join us in prayer and feel the Spirit of Christ that is among us.
And follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine.
I am the word that leads all to freedom. I am the peace the world cannot give. I will call your name, embracing all your pain. Stand up now, walk and live.
Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home.
There are two ministers in the front here. Please call the name.
Thank you. I pray you be our eyes and watch us where we go and help us to be wise in times when we don't know. Let this be our prayer. Place where we'll be safe.
La luce che tu dai,
I pray we'll find your light.
Nel cuore resterà,
and hold it in our hearts.
A ricordarci che,
when stars go out each night,
l'eterna stella sei. Nella mia preghiera,
let this be our prayer.
Quanta fede c'è,
when shadows fill our day.
Lead us to a place,
guide us with your grace.
Give us faith so we'll be saved. Mondo senza più violenza, un mondo di giustizia e di speranza, ognuno di noi la mano sua vicina, simbolo di pace, di fraternità.
And watch us from above.
Ognuno troviamo.
We hope that each soul will find
intorno e dentro sé
another kind to love.
Let this be our prayer.
Let this be our prayer.
Just like every child. Needs to find a place, guide us with your grace, give us faith so we'll be safe. E la fede che hai acceso in noi, sento che ci
Mass has been live streamed today and will be available to watch later today and tomorrow by accessing holycrossrochester.org. So if you have family and friends that were not able to make it and would like to view it, please let them know. The family would like to invite you to a two-hour gathering at Duran Eastman Golf Course Clubhouse, 1200 Kings Highway, immediately following this Mass. At this time, we would invite Jerry's aunt and godmother, Anne, forward to offer some words of remembrance.
Father Whelan, I'd like to thank you for the beautiful words you spoke about Jerry last night and again this morning. I know that you and Jerry had a beautiful personal relationship as well as a spiritual one. And I think when you have those two things, you get to know a person quite well. I'm sure you don't remember, Father, but the night I met you, it was a few years ago, and I found you and Jerry playing poker at a church picnic. Now, I don't play poker, but I am sure you can find something spiritual about a good poker game. I know you and Jerry were very fond of each other. Over these past few days, we've all heard such beautiful words spoken about Jerry. And I would like to say a few things myself this morning. I was thinking of something about Jerry that you haven't heard before. I know something about Jerry that I think only two or three people in this whole world know. So I'm going to begin by telling you that I bought Jerry his first dress. And it wasn't just any dress. It came straight from Paris. Nothing but the best for our boy. And on the day of Jerry's baptism, as Barbara and I put that dress on him, and Michael looked on, we thought he was the most beautiful baby in the whole world. And Jerry grew up to be a fine Christian man, and we were so proud of him. Jerry was a devoted husband to Bonnie, a devoted father to Michael, wonderful son to Mike and Barb, wonderful brother to Sean. And as he was growing up, Jerry brought a great deal of joy to his late grandparents, Ernest and Leona Whaley, and Walter and Helen Murphy. He brought a great deal of joy into their lives. Jerry was also a good uncle. He was a good nephew. He was a good cousin. He was a good friend. He was a good in-law. And speaking of in-laws, it didn't take we Murphys long to we met you Brennans to know that Jerry had married into the right family. People who love to smile and laugh a lot. And we're here today. Our hearts are broken. And our sorrow is almost unspeakable, but we will laugh. You probably will see us laughing before the day is over. Jerry loved life. And I'm reminded of something I read years ago in the book, The Prophet, by Cahill Gibran. He wrote about joy and sorrow. And about sorrow, he said this. He said, when you are sorrowful, look deep into your heart, and you shall see that in truth, you are weeping for that which has been your delight. And how else can it be? You are weeping for that which has been your delight. And that was so true with Jerry. We all watched Jerry and Bonnie with great admiration as they waged war against this disease. And they did it with courage, dignity, and a deep faith in God. None of us wanted this to happen. We hoped and prayed that it wouldn't. And it's difficult to understand why it did. But it's my hope and prayer that we can all take these happy, joyful, loving, fun-filled memories of Jerry and hold them close to our hearts and let them be a source of comfort to us in these days ahead. And so as we are joined here today to send Jerry back to God, I say, Godspeed, my dear boy. I love you with all of my heart, and I always will. Rest in peace, Jerry. Life well lived. Job well done. Thank you. Michael.
Let us stand.
Let us pray. Lord God, your Son left us the sacrament of his body and blood as food for our journey and as a pledge of everlasting life in heaven. May our brother Jerry, who was faithful to the love of God on earth, come to the fullness of love in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
I'd like to extend my sympathies to Bonnie and Michael, to Jerry's family and his extended family, all those people that are here today. What a wonderful sign of Jerry, the crowd in this church, and the crowd that we saw at the funeral home. I want to thank all of you for being here. For what you've done is given us the spirit of Jerry back by your presence, by your love. I want to thank Father Salmon and Father Carioa from McQuaid, who came to celebrate. Father Reef, who's our own assistant here. And I want to thank Ann Johnson and Mary Toot, our whole staff, for all we've done to make this a very special ceremony. Jack, our organist, our resurrection choir, our soloist, Susan and Michael. That duet was just absolutely beautiful. Thank you. And our saxophonist, David. I heard another person playing up in heaven. Jerry was giving a little solo to the angels in heaven as that was being played down here. And I want to recognize, you know, just a tremendous outpouring of love. The men of McQuaid who are here, the teachers and the students, our soccer team, which is very, very evidently here.
Thank you, Bonnie. See, Bonnie keeps track of everything, so she's always there. She's going to straighten me out at any time I need to be straightened out. You know, one of the things I say so often is when we come to this point, if it hadn't been so good, it wouldn't be so bad. And yet it's all those goodness that changes this from mourning into rejoicing. For Jerry blessed us. Jerry taught us about life. Jerry showed us love. Jerry was always there for his wife, his son, his family, anyone. Jerry, you need something to do? Call Jerry. He'd do it. Whether he had time or not, he would do it. He'd sandwich it in at some time. And that poem that's in the beginning of our book, I like the memory of me to be a happy one. I'd like to leave an afterglow of smiles. That's what Jerry would say to us. When we go forth from here, let us go forth with a deep reality of God's losing him, because we will never lose him, for he will always be part of our life, and he will always be looking down on us from heaven. And now we'll have our committal prayers.
Before we go our separate ways, we take leave of our brother Jerry. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, will destroy even death itself.
Him to God. For those who have the leaflets, we are at the inside portion of the back cover. Father, into your hands we commend our brother Jerry in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the many, many blessings which you bestowed on our brother Jerry in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And then in the final portion, after the word all, In peace, let us take our brother Jerry to his place of rest. Together, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
At this time, in honor of Jerry's beloved alma mater, Notre Dame University, we will sing Notre Dame Our Mother. Jerry is and always will be a member of the Notre Dame family, and in that spirit, I encourage all of you to sing along with me. The words can be found on the back of the program.
Notre Dame, our mother, tender, strong, and true, proudly in the heavens gleams thy gold and blue. Glory's mantle cloaks thee ever. Praise thee, Notre Dame, and our hearts forever love thee, Notre Dame.